Measure of dispersion for ungrouped data, KSSM Mathematics Form 4, advantages and disadvantages of various measures of dispersion, example 10 to example 11, page 224. The range is the measure of dispersion easiest to calculate. However, the range cannot provide a good overview of how data is distributed. For example, the following data. In case where there is an outlier or extreme value, for example 1, 2, 90, and 100. Most of the data are in between 38 to 60. 1, 2, 90, and 100, they are called outlier or extreme value. The interquartile range would be the more appropriate measure for dispersion to show the distribution of data. For example, if we find the range, then the range is 100 minus 1 equal to 99. And if we tell other people that the range of data is 99, they may think that the spread of data is a lot. However, it's not the case. If we find the interquartile range, the quartile range is equal to third quartile minus first quartile. Before that, we need to find the median. Median is here. Before median, there are 6 data. After median, there are 6 data. For the third quartile, the median is here. So third quartile is average of 50 and 60, equal to 55. And for the first quartile, the median is here. So the average of 38 and 40 is 39. So interquartile range is equal to 55 minus 39 equal to 16. If we tell other people that the interquartile range of the data is only 16, then they know that the spread of data is small. Standard deviation is usually used to compare two sets of data. In general, a low standard deviation indicates that the data is dispersed close to the mean, while a high standard deviation indicates that the data is dispersed far from the mean. Example 10. Calculate the range and interquartile range of the set of data. Then determine the most appropriate measure of dispersion to be used to measure the distribution of the dataset. Solution. First, make sure the data must be sorted from small to big. So the range is equal to the maximum value 40 minus the minimum value 10. So the range is equal to 30. Interquartile range equal to third quartile minus first quartile. And first quartile is the value of data in the middle of position of the part of data before the median, and third quartile is the value of the data in middle position of the part of data after the median, before textbook 220. So we need to find the median. So median is here. For median, there are 6 data. After median, also there are 6 data. Then the first quartile is here. And the third quartile is here. So 21 minus 11. So we get 10. Interquartile range is the most appropriate measure of dispersion because the existence of the outlier 40. Example 11. The table below shows the achievement of 2 pupils in 5 physics tests. One of the pupils will be selected to represent the school in a physics quiz competition. Determine who is eligible to be selected and justify your answer solution. So we find the mean for Ayman first. Mean marked is equal to. So there are 5 tests. And then we find the average of all the score. So the mean mark is 69.8. Standard deviation is equal to. So same. Here is 5. And then square all the numbers and add them out. Then minus mean square. Okay, remember square. So standard deviation is 17.67. Then we find for John. The mean marks for John is. So there are 5 tests too. Then find the average of the score. And so the mean for John is 69.8, same with Ayman. Then you find the standard deviation. So 5, same. Square all the scores and minus the mean. And remember to square. And so standard deviation is 7.574. So both of them have the same mean mark, but they have difference of standard deviation. Ayman's score is dispersed far from the mean as his score has higher standard deviation. However, John's score is dispersed close to the mean as his score has lower standard deviation. In conclusion, John will be selected to participate in the physics quiz competition. The standard deviation of John's score is lower because John's achievement is more consistent.